church. I forgot the name of the church. Warren, when y'all see this naming, hey, we're here. We're about to go inside and partake of this wedding.
Be against these two becoming husband and wife. Now's your time to speak up. There's nobody. At least not us. So, who gives this beautiful lady to be married today?
Her mother and myself.
Thank you, may be seated. Like I said, this is a very special occasion. There are moments that people get married. There are moments that people become in a union with God. And I've been able to witness their union with God as their pastor. And I look forward to this opportunity now as you becoming husband and wife in God's eyes. Let's pray together. God, I thank you for friendship, but I thank you for kinship through the blood of the Lamb. And Lord, this is a holy time. It's a very important time. And I pray, God, that you would just lead my lips and guide my heart. As Father, as we go through this ceremony, may it honor you. And at the same time, Father, may your spirit abound in this place. Thank you for this day, for this moment. It's in Jesus, your name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
You know, we've gathered here today in the sight of God and our friends and our family. And it is a special occasion. Do you realize, Warren, that when God created heaven and earth, that he created you with purpose to be living in his image? Now, if you're like me, there's been times that I didn't portray a very good image of God. But from this day forward, you have a real big old responsibility. It's going to be the one that God designed just for you with purpose. And Amie, Warren will not be your husband, but he will be the one who will give you comfort. And not only will he give you comfort, he'll give you comfort when it seems like the world's throwing rocks at you. He will be your shield and comfort. He's going to stand the test of time for you. When you say, in a little bit, till death do us part, it's a covenant between you and God, not between you and you. You're making a covenant to God. God, you created this woman for me. I'm taking it. I'm going to protect her. I'm going to love her. I'm going to cherish her. And that big responsibility is to be the image of Christ before the bride that God is giving you today. Now, Amie, you know, in the creation altogether, God created man first. And God looked upon man as his prime example of his creation for a purpose to oversee the garden. But one day he noticed that the man was very lonely. The man was incomplete. In fact, if you study Genesis chapter 2, you're going to find that God, after he created things, he said, and this is good. He didn't say that about a woman or any man. But he did say this: it is not good for man to be by himself. So therefore, he created you. He created woman. Now, when he did that, he calls a sleep go upon Warren. Many men realize it's that sleep in a recliner on Saturday afternoon about this time, or Sunday after church. But that particular day, God caused Warren to go to sleep for a reason, because he was going to create a woman. And he took from Warren, not from his head, so that you could be his boss and have that mind set to be the boss of the husband. Nor did he take from your feet so that you could trample all over her. You see, there was a divine appointment and divine purpose in his creation. If you remember that story, he took a rib from the left side of the man, right next to his heart, and with the purpose that you would love her, that you would cherish her, and that you would be there for her. Isn't that cool? That is great. God did that for this particular time in your life. You know, years back, you didn't know about this guy. God did. Years back, life could have been upside down. God knew this guy. Years back, you didn't know this lady. And life could have been upside down. And if you're normal, it probably was upside down. But God knew this lady. Why? Because he created you for such a time as this. In today's society, a lot of people, man, they're falling in lust with each other. But they're not falling in love with each other. And that is the key issue of what I want to kind of nail down to today, is that this is not a lust marriage. This is a love relation marriage. Totally designed by God. Can't nobody else do that. Okay? So we understand that together. And so today, Adam, I want you to understand what God said, yes, but what Adam said. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 23, Adam says this: "This is my bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman." It didn't say God called her woman. Man named her woman. That was the responsibility that God had given to Adam, remember, to name all the created things that he had made. So he took from you, and you were able to name her as woman. That in itself is awesome. "She shall be called woman because she was taken out of me," taken out of man. "Therefore," now this is where moms and dads needs to be listening up, okay? Because Adam says in that scripture, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Do you know what 1 + 1 equals in God's eyes? It's common core math, 1. 1 + 1 in God's eyes is 1. Because you come in here separate today, but you will leave as 1. Pretty awesome, huh? Yes, only a God thought of that. Okay? Only God can think of that. So, Warren, is not only going, Amy's not going to only be your wife, she is going to be part of you. She becomes part of you. She will be your helpmate. If you will let her. She will not be your slave. I got an amen from the best baby. She will be your comfort in times of struggle. She is as your shepherd, as your spiritual leader and crazy friend. I require you to promise to love, cherish her, to honor her, to sustain her in sickness as in health, in poverty as in wealth, and in the bad that may darken your days, and in the good that may even brighten your days. So Warren.
Yes, sir.
Warren Blank, is that right?
Yes.
I am at the right wedding.
Okay. Also.
Do you promise that to Amy? Amy, in taking Warren by your hands there to be your husband, as your friend, and as your shepherd, as your pastor, as a shoulder, as a listener, as one that will encourage you, will you take Warren as your husband, and will you promise him to be the love of your life, and to cherish him and honor him and sustain him in sickness and in health? And let me just interject. When we guys are ill, we need extra help. Because we are wired. Do you so promise? This is right on the line. You know, in seriousness, in just a minute, we're going to be looking at a ring ceremony where you guys are going to place an instrument on each other's hand, on your ring finger. And that is to be worn 24/7. You know? Sometimes you'll be working on the car, you won't even take it off. But when you're in a public place, when you're in those situations, maybe perhaps a temptation, that is the time you need it on, because it's not only a reminder to you, it's a reminder to the world. He's mine. Girls, keep your hands to yourself. You know what I mean? Okay. Now, I understand that you guys have written some vows, your own personal vows, things that you want to say, and you have written them down, so if you like me, you don't forget. So at this time, I'm going to ask that our men will step over out of your way, and you guys step over to the unity candle. This is y'all's time. Take your time. Let this be an intimate heart time for you. And then when you're finished, you'll come back here, and we'll pray over your vows that you've done. And then we'll go on with the ring ceremony. And then you'll get to kiss your bride. All right? So if you would make your way over. The ring is a sign of everlasting
lasting love.
There's no breaks in it. I don't know if you remember when when you were little, you'd get those rings out of the gun machine and always had that crack in them. Yeah. Pretty well said it all right there. Like, this isn't going to last very long. But this is complete. Gold stands for purity. The diamonds, the riches of Christ. The riches of Christ. That's the blessing that you're going to be able to have on your hand. And it comes from his heart. And it comes with true meaning. So Warren, I'd like for you to take this ring. And on Amie's left hand, and that ring finger, you slide that right on up there. And hold it, if you will. And repeat after me. Amie, I take you to be my wedded wife. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer or poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and cherish till death do us part. And according to God's holy ordinance. And with this ring. I pledge my love to you.
We have one for Mr. Warren.
Warren, same thing goes for this. You see, it's a continuous circle. It goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on. And the key thing about it, the gold, of course, purity, but the circle itself goes because you're the spiritual leader of the home. That this relationship doesn't stop here on the face of the earth. It goes on and on and on and on throughout eternity. Now, you may separate for a while here on the face of the earth, but you'll be joined together in eternity. That doesn't mean husband and wife. But that goal, that promise, that you get to spend eternity together. So you get to spend a life here on earth and then eternity there. So, Amie, would you take that ring and place it on Warren's left hand on his ring finger, and while holding it there, would you repeat after me? Warren. I take you to be my husband.
I take you to be my husband.
To have and hold from this day forward. For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
Amen.
For poor.
In sickness and in health. To love and cherish. Till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance. And with this ring. I pledge my love to you and you alone.
I pledge my love to you and to you alone.
Warren and Amie, just a few moments ago, you walked in here as best friends. In a moment. When I announce, you're going to be walking away as best lovers, protectors of each other, husband and wife. And because of the authority that is given to me by the state of Oklahoma and by God to be able to stand in this holy place with you, seeking his will for your life. And according to you making a promise to each other, a pledge, the scripture calls it a holy covenant, a contract. And that's what this is. Guess what? I can announce you, not Warren Plank and Amie Mason, but husband. And wife, you may kiss your bride. At this time, I would like to announce to you Mr. and Mrs. Warren Plank and their sidekick son, Sammy. Give them a hand. They are going to be leaving at this time, but I'm going to ask that they're going to be coming back in to take pictures immediately. You guys will be dismissed. You will go down this hall to your left, and there's a fellowship hall down there with food and things of that nature for you. I would like to have a word of prayer just to bless the field, the food. That's right. I'm getting that right. To bless the food, okay? Father, I thank you for this day. It's very important. We've laughed. But Father, there is so genuineness here in reality that you designed husband and wife for purpose to fulfill your will on this face of the earth. We pray that they would be able to do that. Lord, it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hey guys, it's been a long day. Got back from Woodward. I'm sitting here doing some editing for this video. Man, I want to thank my brother Eric for going out with me today out to Woodward. Hope you enjoyed it. See some things maybe you've never seen before. Western Oklahoma is a beautiful place, especially northwestern Oklahoma. Big congrats to Warren and Amie. Beautiful wedding today. Wish you guys the best. Seek God first in everything you do in your marriage, and all things will be added to you. Guys, like and subscribe, please. Trying to retire. Been in education for 30 years. Would like to retire and maybe make a living right here doing YouTube. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching Ensco's Adventures. I will see you guys on the next video.